Yes.
We're doing couch edition, yo.
Gotta sit.
After chatting these for like we own chairs. So here we are.
On a chair that we own.
I'm very proud to say. We are taking it back to the basics.
We want to much show, like Christina
Aguilera.
There you go.
Yes, we are taking it back to the basics. We want to kind of break down some wine accessories for you.
You need accessories.
You need accessories. You need them. We don't have many of them, but we're saying you
need you should
them.
Go and purchase them.
That's your business.
Yes.
Leather.
Now you know why Eddie Murphy called it raw.
Raw. Okay, what should we talk about first?
Let's talk about wine openers.
Yes, let's talk about wine openers. So, I know that a lot of people are very intimidated by some wine openers, and I'm not saying that's Genesis. But it's not Genesis, okay? Now listen, I have messed up many a cork.
I haven't messed up any corks, but you know what I'm saying? It's 2020, why make it harder for myself?
Listen, I have been in front of a customer breaking their cork, thinking to myself, oh God, this is it. I'm gonna get fired today. But you know what? You managed to make it out in the end. But I have two very handy ones that we own.
By Fenty.
Two very handy ones. This is the easier one. I'd have to say, yes, look at our ticker in. And then this is a slightly more difficult one.
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
Yes, so the whole thing with this is that it has a double hinge. So that makes it a little bit easier than ones that would only have a single hinge right here. So because you have this double sort of hinge motion right here, you're able to sort of pull the cork up in two different motions. So if you're going to get a corkscrew that's going to look like this, be sure to get one where you can see two little hinges. That's very important, okay? I'm telling you.
Oh.
Okay, anyway, you get the fucking point.
What about the Swiss Army knife that it comes with?
So I got this from CIA. Holla! So it has many different accoutrements here. We have the actual corkscrew, which is right here. So that's gonna go into the cork. And then this is the little knife that you use to cut the paper that's around the top of the bottle.
Yeast.
Okay, so this is a double winged corkscrew, and this is very fun. This is what I used to, you know, open all my parents' bottles of wine when they would ask me to go get them some wine. I would use this because it definitely is easier. So you put this part on top of the bottle, like that.
Like that.
We love us some Tabitha Brown. So you put it in like that, and then you screw, and these slowly go up. And then when it's at the tippity top, you use both your hands and pull it down, and it brings up
the cork. Yes.
Yes.
The main difference with this little guy is that the wings are doing the work for you. in the other one, whereas you're doing the work.
You're doing the work
for you.
And this definitely requires more precision. You have to get right in the center of the cork. So it's definitely a little bit more advanced, but once you get it, which I don't even completely have it, so it takes a while.
Yeah. But it's not bad.
It's not bad.
It's just
a mini heart attack every time you open wine, just to get the blood flowing.
So here we have some Whole Foods wine.
Yes,
that we picked up. We risked it all outside of quarantine to be in the parking lot with 3,000 other
human beings.
It's like, why am I Mad Maxing this for some oranges
and lemons? It's bad every time. And there's always one person. There's always gonna be one person that makes you regret ever leaving your house.
Literally. And you think, like, even though you can't see my face, I'm
pure anger. Unadulterated anger.
So anyways, yes.
Anyway, so Publix, I mean
Dickie Publix.
Okay, all so right. We have a Grenache for you.
Ooh.
Yes.
A
California.
Central Coast.
Grenache. So the first thing we're gonna do is make a cut on this paper. Just try to go straight up and down. It's okay if you can't or don't. It takes a lot of strength, more so than you think. And then you're gonna wanna cut the paper and take this top off. Take your top off.
I shouldn't have laughed so hard, but it's funny.
Then you get rid of that. This is what you have. Yes, ooh. Magazine and wine potty, ooh. And then we're gonna go in right in the center. Push down using a good amount of force. And then keep it steady going all the way down so it remains in the center. I usually go to about here. You can go a little bit more if you're comfortable with that. And then you go to the first hinge, pull up as much as you can. Second hinge. And you don't want to pop it out. You want to slowly work it out of the...
Yes, love that sound.
Ooh. So we don't want to glug, we want to slowly pour it in there. Oh, look at that color.
That is gorgeous. She is giving lady in pink, you know, a magenta. Yes.
So that's a good amount for wine, and especially when you're in a bowl, you want to get to-
Allegedly.
if you're doing a proper serve in front of the in-laws or whatever it may be, or if you have a rounded, more classic red wine glass, you would want to do it right below where the widest part of the glass is.
Yeah, so why don't we talk about wine glasses, yes. Baby? Oh, glasses.
My glasses. You wanna cheers on this so we can
sit down? Oh my god, yes. Cheers.
Cheers. She's open up.
Let's talk about decanters.
So, a decanter. I'm sorry. Y'all know what I'm referencing, right? It's the Taylor Swift shit where she was talking about where she became the face of tourism in New York.
You're laughing,
but it's true.
The face? Her face?
She literally became like the ambassador of tourism or something in New York. Oh, and she had this awful video.
Good for her.
She had this awful video where she was like, a bodega is a corner shop. It was not good. Anyway, we're past that. So a decanter is a wine accessory that you use to sort of aerate your wine so it can develop more strong flavors, so it can open up properly, so it's not as tannic. This is just a wonderful device for wine that sometimes very clearly needs it.
Yes. So when you guys hear terms like opening up, it's not you drunk at Thanksgiving. It is a wine. Too soon.
Too close.
It's exactly that. It's the wine opening up to the air.
So even just the action of pouring it into a different vessel gives it the sort of air, push of air that it needs into it. And just being able to just let it sit out on a counter and let it breathe for 30, 45 minutes if it's a glass of red wine.
Yes.
Yes.
All right, so let's talk about wine glasses. So there are three major, well, there are a bajillion different types of, ooh, I know, she's strong, baby. She is strong, independent, a little too much.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about it. We're gonna talk about this grape. All right, sorry.
But there are many a type of wine glasses, and you can really, you know, delve it down to the occasion and what you're eating, but there are three main types of wine glasses.
Yes.
Red, white, blue, no, sparkling.
So sparkling is probably the most recognizable, right? It's the flute, it's the really tall glass, so the sparkles and the bubbles really bubble up to the top. It looks really gorgeous. And that's also to keep the bubbles in.
Yes,
if you
and
have,
that,
sorry?
I was just gonna say something funny. The glass is giving you, check out, I'm blonde. I'm skinny.
I'm rich.
And I'm a little bit of a bitch.
I wanna dress you up in silk. Anyway, okay, so we often drink, as you see, as everyone sees, because we keep on posting it, we drink our sparkling from
these cute little martini glasses.
And that's not because we want to.
It's because aesthetic, we're dying. No, it's because that's what's around.
That's what's around. We do have really cute, small flutes.
Oh yeah, it's the color,
but they're not big enough. I'm an alcoholic,
right.
Not a Barbie. Give me a bigger one. You know what I mean? So it's just like, we gotta have a bigger vessel. So that's the only reason that we use the martini glasses. It's not proper, you know, it's not proper etiquette by any means.
And I'm also still learning how to make a good martini. Look on me.
Both fun. Yes, so a red wine glass. There are many different types of red wine glasses,
yes.
But the most popular that you see is going to be the rounded bottom. And that's so
much like mine, rounded.
Much
bottom.
Like your rounded. So, red wine glasses are going to be rounder and bigger at the base because it allows for more aroma to travel around the glass and for it to open up more. So, you stick your big old nose in. Really gonna sniff in that puppy.
Yes.
I mean, I know you've seen someone at a fancy dinner just absolutely stick half of their face into a glass, trying to just get a sniff of that. That's because that is really, really valued. And that's how you become a better, what am I trying to say?
Wine enthusiast.
A better taster too,
yes.
Because you really have to work your nose if you want to be good at being able to place wine. Your nose is going to be the most helpful thing for you. And so if you can't pick up on certain smells, if you can't be able to get like 80% of the information from the nose, it's gonna be really difficult for you once you start tasting.
Yes.
So sniff all the wine you can, I beg of you.
Yes.
Get your nose in there.
Why are white wine glasses? Oh, that's aggressive.
White wine glasses are shaped the way that they are, more of a U shape, because they are chilled. So to retain the cool temperatures, God, do I sound stupid?
Stay cool, friends.
Yes,
and those are the three main wine glasses. But like,
there's also dessert wine,
yes,
which is going to be a little tiny baby glass. But it's going to be a really small wine glass, very tiny.
Yes.
Really, I don't like dessert wine.
I don't like dessert wines. Why am I drinking this sugar juice? It's just too much. But yes, but don't get too hung up about it. Like, you've seen us drink sparkling out of martini glasses. And what? Yes. But this is just for your knowledge, in case you finally take your girlfriend out to a nice dinner, you piece of shit. Sorry, we'll edit that out. I don't know what's happening. It's the moonlight.
Come alive in the night in the moonlight. Yes, I'm
one of them with you. Hey!
Hey. Because also, we're sitting on the couch. It's a little bit of a relaxed.
Oh, you know, yeah, that's what it is. It's too relaxed.
So, we hope you enjoyed our little bit more, you know, I don't know, relaxed is the word.
Relaxed is the word that I would say. But also practical. Like, definitely, if you guys have other questions about wine that you're too embarrassed to ask or what have you, please come forward. We're bored. It's quarantine.
Ask me.
Me.
Oh, right. We're wearing black. We're really bringing in the,
yes.
Bringing in the, what is it? The holiday season.
Yes. All right, y'all boys. Well, let us know what y'all drinking this week, or if you just drinking.
Just drinking, baby.
All right. Cheers.